Where were you on 9/11? That question has become part of the fabric of our lives as Americans. On 9/11, I was with a hero. I was with John McKenna. On that beautiful cloudless morning that seemed to promise nothing but goodness, John and his dear wife, Molly, were about to pull out of the driveway for a much needed and long overdue vacation. But when news of the attack came over the radio, they both knew that Montauk would have to wait. Molly kissed him goodbye, urged him to be careful, as she had done every day for the almost 30 years that he served and protected the city. And then John headed for Ground Zero. Where were you on 9/11? On September 11, 2001, John McKenna saved more than 100 lives. See this? It's worn by the first responders that day. John could wear it as proudly as anyone who was there. Why them and not me? As a cop, I've asked myself that question many times. But I have come to realize that just about any New Yorker could ask themselves the same question. And some questions have no answers. All that is left for we the living to do is honor them, take care of them, and rededicate ourselves to the cause for which they gave the last full measure of devotion. John, may the road rise up to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. The rains fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand.